And gentlemen, this will be a bit of a short one because I do have to get back to work. Although I don't start for a couple more hours still, I had an early start to the day, so I want to make sure that I get some more work done on my actual 9 to 5, or as I joke, my 5 to 9 job. But we have an interesting thing that's come up today. First off, we're going to go here to the little wargame source. We're going to make sure that we're actually just sourcing little wargame instead of alt tab, right? Because now you can't see what I'm alt tabbing over to, which is excellent. So, Aver says, out of curiosity, I started skin watching some YouTube videos on making an RTS in Unity, and I noticed most people go for a sci-fi vibe. But then I thought, hey, if Little Wargame has like a new race, Little Wargame, the game that we're all here for, it could be some kind of sci-fi race. It doesn't fit the vibe, perhaps. I mean, it doesn't normally, because Little Wargame does have a very like low fantasy, mid fantasy, I would say mid fantasy medieval time frame, right? This is more like a Garth Brooks kind of. Or a Garth Nix, rather, not Brooks. Jeez, that's a singer. That's a country singer. More of a Garth Nix abhorrence vibe than anything else, right? But I'm sure one could come up with some lore to make it all work or whatever. Who knows if I get bored and try to make a mine a little wargame for giggles. How hard is it? Here's the question. How hard is it to get going modding with little wargame? I am spewing words. Shall have a gander through the forums. Pekka then says, modding in a new race is pretty easy. Probably best to first take a look at how vanilla things are implemented and learn like that. With the exception of Raider Flash, which is like Blink from Stalkers for StarCraft 2, for anyone who's not familiar, I don't think any vanilla features are hard to understand the inner workings of. Now, once upon a time, I thought about making, and in fact, I believe I did make a video of, here's how you get started in the little wargame editor. And I really thought, because this is the way my brain worked, I really thought that people wanted to hear, like, okay, so listen, here's the whole editor. We're gonna go line by line and explain what every single thing does. And I just realized no one makes projects like that. Like, I didn't realize it until I started making some Game Maker Studio project and Unreal Engine projects. Nobody learns by going through every single item of what you can make and then being told, oh yeah, this is what you do. What we learn is we learn by doing projects. We learn by finding out something, and then we slowly get curious about what this thing over here is, and we expand our reach a little bit, and that's how we grow our skills. So fundamentally, the answer question is, how do we make a new race? And the fundamental answer I'm going to provide is, I said this in response, but now I'm going to do the part that I talked about at the end. I said, adding a race or faction will seem challenging, but it's a great place to start with the editor. It's a series of small learning points. I'd start with learning how to add a new building to workers, how to add new units to those buildings and make them trainable. Right? That's three. And how to add new upgrades. Start with attack and defense upgrades. Four things. That's all we're going to do. How to add a new building to workers so that the workers can construct the building. How to add new units to those buildings and make them trainable. That's two and three. We need new units, and then we need to be able to make those new units. And how to add new upgrades. So we're going to go ahead and go through all of those pretty quickly. So this is a brand new map. So we're going to go ahead here and we're going to go to data. Now, this continuing will convert this map into a modded map. Just say yes. So the first thing I want to emphasize is that when you're doing anything in the editor, there are some defaults, and they haven't all been fully mapped out in the Little Wargame editor, that if you change that default value, you will bork your entire game, right? Some are like attack ground, attack, move to, right? But sometimes there are ones that you don't expect that if you change, like if you change too much of the base heal, for instance, you might find your mod just unplayable. So what we do in general is we take something that exists and we copy it. So what we're going to do first is, I said how to add a new building to workers. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. We're not going to cover any of the graphics or any of that other complicated stuff. What we're first going to do is going to go to the units tab, okay? And I'm a big fan of copying stuff, so we're going to go new. And we're going to copy from the worker, okay? And the ID string, we're just going to call this a new worker, right? Or we're just going to call it, yeah, we'll just call this new faction worker. And then we're going to make new faction worker. When you're working in the editor, right? I want to show you something. No, what we won't do that. Don't use symbols or numbers, right? As a general rule, for the ID string, make it all lowercase, and then camel case. This is something you'll see in programming and software development proper, language specific, of course. Camel case it so that you can see it. The reason we do new faction worker is that lowercase n is alphabetically after all of the capital letters, and all of the default items are capital. So you'll be making bam, new faction worker here at the bottom. It's a brand new worker. That's all it is. It's just a worker. Okay, and our new faction worker looks like a regular worker, but let's keep the stuff that's here for now, okay? So what we're going to do, this is very simple. We're just going to have a new worker, and we're going to have, you want to give yourself a house, because even in tests, if you don't have a house or some other building that prevents loss, you'll just lose immediately. So let's go ahead and test with our worker. Yep, it's a worker, all right. So it has basic buildings, human buildings, beast buildings, mechanical buildings. What we're going to do here is we're going to add a new section, right? And we're going to make a T block here that's going to be called new faction buildings, right? You see how we have human buildings, beast buildings, mechanical buildings? We're going to make a new CC or a new switch command card here because this is the command card. And then that way our new faction worker will be able to make stuff from our new faction. So F10 plus N. So we're going to go over here. Remember how that said human buildings, beast buildings? Well, those are all abilities. So let's go to mechanical buildings because mechanical was R on the top row. So we're going to go to mechanical buildings. So this is a switch CC, which switches the command card. By default, you're on command card 0. And so it says command card 0. And a target CC is a command card of number 4. Okay, well, we're not going to do that. We're going to keep 4, but we're going to copy this mechanical buildings. Here, let me move it over to the side. So this is what we're copying, mechanical buildings, okay? We have to look for it a little bit. It'll take some effort because we're copying from the images, or we're copying from the, rather, from the abilities. Mech. It's going to take a little time. I've never copied from this one before, but this will be part of, there we go. So mechanical buildings. And instead of, so the ID string of mechanical buildings is mech underscore buildings. We're just going to call this new faction underscore buildings. You see what we're doing here? Clever. New faction buildings, right? And once again, when we create this, it'll go all the way down to the bottom. Now this new faction buildings, we have to do two things to make this work for us, right? So the first is that we start on command card 0. This is where, so when you click a unit, all the controls that that unit has are on command card 0. What you're looking at for that unit is command card 0 by default. And this is a switch command card or a switch CC. It takes a command card, which is where we start, in this case 0, our starting command card, and it goes to a target command card. Now, if you're wondering, how do I create a command card? We don't have to worry about that yet. That's not a thing yet. So we're just going to go and make the target CC 5. Okay? And we're going to change. I don't know what you want your faction to look like. We're gonna pick some new item. It doesn't matter what. I'm just showing you that this will be a new ability. The hotkey. We don't want it to be R. We want it to be T. And why? Because we have Q, W, E, R already. So T, Q, W, E, R, T is going to be really smooth and easy for most people using QWERTY computers. Now the interface, this is where it's located. So by default, the one that we copy, there is an X position and a Y position. So let's do the one we're not changing first, the Y position. Well, it says 0 is the top row and 1 is the bottom row. We want it to be up here with Q, W, E, R, and we want T to be to the right of R. So we don't want to change Y. We want it to be on the top row. But the X position, now this is a little more confusing, but it says 0 is very left, 4 is the very right. Well, we want it to be on the very right, so we'll just make this 4. Now, there's one thing you have to do. It's great that we've made new faction buildings, but now this ability, this switch command card ability, has to be given to our new faction worker. So let's go to our new faction worker. We're going to scroll down until we see commands. You'll know it's commands because it has all these. Stop, hold position, attack, move, move to, repair, mine, build buildings, all of this other stuff. You don't have to worry about any of this. You don't have to worry about any of this. Just go to add. We scroll all the way down to the bottom. Because by default, when you make a new ability, a new unit, a new building, a new modifier, it is added to the bottom of the list. Just scroll straight to the bottom, and we click New Faction Buildings, and we're going to add. So now our new faction worker has an ability called New Faction Buildings. So remember how we said we want to add a new building to workers? This is like part 0.5. So we're going to save, and now we're going to test. Now look at our new faction worker. Holy shit, it has basic buildings, human buildings, beast buildings, mechanical buildings, and new faction buildings. I can't wait to see what our new faction... There's nothing there. Well, of course there aren't. Just like we added T for the new faction buildings, we're going to have to add new cards in here. Let's use an example of human building. So when you press W for human building, you can see that you can build a barracks, build a mage's guild, build an armory, build a church. So what we're going to do is, because I'm partial to Rax, we're going to copy the build barracks command, and we're going to put that on the new faction buildings command. And this will get us to where we have a new command card, and we can make a new building. So let's go ahead and F10 and plus N. Okay, let's send this up over here. Nice. Okay, so cool. So what we're going to do is, much the same way how there was make, build, you know, we did mechanical building, now we're going to copy a make ability, right? So we're going to go over here, and we're going to go to, I'm going to scroll down a little bit so that we can see this guy. We're going to go to build, we're going to go to the abilities for make building, okay? So we're going to do this in order. Not the order I would do it, but the order you should think about it. It'll help you with the editor a lot. So we want to build barracks or make barracks. Okay. Let's go ahead to buildings, build watchtower, mage, barracks, build barracks. So build barracks is an ability. It is of type make building. And unit type, or the type of building we're making, is a barracks. So we're going to go ahead and copy this. This looks exactly like what we want. Notice you can't move this little box for the new object, but you can move this box behind it. Quirk of the editor. Feel free to enjoy. So we're going to look for build barracks. As soon as we find it, there's build barracks. Now notice that the ID string for this is build barracks. We don't want to call this build barracks. We want to call this like build faction barracks or something like that. So we're just going to call this like, I don't even know what you want to call the barracks. Let's call it like a what do you, we'll just call it clippers because I'm seeing some nail clippers in front of me, right? So build clippers, right? Build, and then what we do is we call this ability build lowercase we can either do build clippers like this, but if we want to make this look somewhat normal, we can also put a Z in front of it. So we're just going to call it Z build clippers. Again, this is just a barracks. This is just the build barracks command, but notice, why did we call it Z build clippers? Because now we have the capital B, but Z is a lowercase letter, puts it all the way down to the bottom. You can do any of this that you want. In fact, generally, when you're done with a building or you're done with a mod, you'll clean these up, right? We don't want to do it right now because, look, if we get rid of the Z, it'll go back somewhere up here in the B area, and that'll be hard to find. We keep it at the bottom. Okay, this will make your life so much easier. So now, Z build clippers. It's of type make building. Sick. It makes a barracks. I don't care about that yet. Its hotkey is Q. Okay, what command card is it on? Now, this is important. We made the switch command card for our new faction to go from command card 0 to command card 5. So we actually want to now make the command card of this ability not appear on 2. We want it to appear on 5. So let's go ahead and put this on 5. Interface X is 0, puts it on the very left. Y of 0 puts it up top, so it's in the upper left-hand side. The image that it has is a barracks. It has a requirement that we build a house. Let's not change any of this. Okay, so remember, once again, just because you've created a new ability, you need a unit to actually act it out in the world. So we're going to go down to the commands of our new faction worker. We're going to hit add. We're going to scroll all the way to the bottom. And we're going to put in build clippers. Okay? X, save. You always save because sometimes the editor will bork out or the server will crash or your mod, you'll change something that'll cause a race condition. You have no idea the ways that you could mess it up, but you could always be safe if you just click save. And then we'll test. It'll go to your downloads folder by default. So notice, we have T for our new faction buildings. And we have Z, you know, with Q here for our Z build clippers ability. Now, we don't have enough gold for that. And the duration is pretty long. And in fact, it's just a barracks. So let's do a couple of things, right? So when you're testing your mod, you're going to want to be able to have enough resources to test things, right? It's a lot easier to cheat and give yourself more than you should have than it is to change the value of everything. So for now, we're going to ignore all of this, and we're just going to say our starting gold is 500. Yeah. Okay, test it again. So we go here, we press T to go to our new faction buildings, we go to build clippers, and bam, we're building a barracks? Well, that's not right. I mean, it's called build clippers, not build barracks. Now, this is where we have to get to the final part of the first bit. So we've done the first part, right? So let's go over it. How to add a new building to workers. Well, the worker can go to a new command card for their new faction, and we've created an ability where they can get to making a new building. All we have to do now is make that building actually new. So if you're following along, you're going to guess what we're doing here. We're going to go over to buildings, and we're going to copy the barracks. Okay? And we're going to call this, like, new faction barracks. You know, new faction barracks. And we'll just call this new faction barracks. Cool. Now, this new faction barracks, just to prove that we're doing something a little different with it, right? What we're going to do is we have to change some values. Now, the building will have inside of it how much gold it costs and how long it takes to build. So the first one we'll go ahead and change right now. It's gold cost. Or cost. So right down here, you have to scroll about to where this is, about a third of the way down, and you'll see cost, the amount of gold it costs to build this unit, in this case to build this building. We're going to change this from 125 to 200, okay? Just to prove that we've actually done that. Now, here's another thing that we're going to do. How long does it take this to build? I mean, I've seen mods from Dragon Archer Z where he has a building build in like 10 seconds. How does he do that? Well, there's an ability or a field you can modify called build time. So we're going to scroll down until we find build time. It's actually 2 above cost. The time it takes to build this building in seconds. Okay, so this is how many, this is 40 seconds by default. So we're going to change this to 10 seconds. That's 4 times faster, right? Now, here's one thing that we have to do. Remember that ability that we had, build clippers? The reason we just made that building is that build clippers is a type make building ability. And the building it makes is the barracks. But we've just made a new building, and we've changed it. So we're going to scroll down and have it make not a barracks, but a new faction barracks. Okay. We're going to do one more thing, just to show that you're being a little spicy. So this description, we're not going to go into how all of this description works, what the BR means, how the get field works, etc. So all we're going to do is, you need to know that when it says barracks here, we just put in the ID string of the building that we made. We made out the name New Faction Barracks, right? This is the ID string of the new building. So instead of barracks, we're just going to call this New Faction Barracks. We're going to move over to the right, and we're going to make its name New Faction Barracks. And then we're going to go over to the right a little bit more, and we're going to change that from barracks.description to New Faction Barracks. Now, we don't have to add a new ability to the worker. The worker already has the ability build clippers. Well, I should have called it clippers instead, but oh, that's fine. We'll get there, right? So what we're going to do is we don't have to actually change the ability that we changed the ability the worker had. We didn't have to add a new ability to the worker. We're going to prove that right now. Save and test. We go to here to T, new faction buildings. Build clippers. Now, it says, notice here that the cost is 200 gold, and the duration is 10 seconds, because we put in the new faction barracks as our description, or our clippers. We're going to build it. Now, watch, I'm at 500 gold, now I'm at 300 gold. Notice how this is going to build much faster than a normal barracks is going to build. That's because we changed the cost and the build time. And so this is the first part of it complete, how to add a new building to the worker. So we have a worker, he can go to a new faction building, and he can build clippers, which is our new building. But our building makes soldiers, archers, raiders, and mages. this isn't what we wanted, right? We wanted to add new units, and we want those new units to be trainable. Well, we're going to go ahead and fix that. So the way that a building makes things is that it's used, remember, whenever you find the name of something in the editor, you can look for that name under the units, buildings, abilities, upgrades, or modifiers, typically under units, buildings, or abilities, and you'll find it. So we saw make soldier. So let's go down to make soldier, or train soldier. Train soldier. Okay, this is the ability that was making the soldier inside of our units building. So let's go to our buildings, our new faction barracks, or our clippers, as we can call it. Go down until we see the commands. So the commands here are train soldier, train archer, train raider, and train mage. All you need to think of commands are commands are the abilities that that building or unit has access to. All commands are just abilities. A move is an ability. Research fireball is an ability. Train raider is an ability, right? All of those things are abilities. So what we're going to do here is we're going to get rid of our soldier, archer, raider, mage. These aren't the new faction units that we want. And to prove that that was effective, we're going to save and test. We're going to go over to here. We're going to make our clippers building. And once it's done in about 10 seconds, we're going to see that there's actually no abilities there. There's nothing that can get done there. There's nothing being used here. Look, we're going to go to our new faction barracks and... But it has no abilities because we took out the four commands that already existed. And because we had no commands, there are no abilities that this new faction barracks, that this build clippers, has access to. But remember how we saw a trained soldier? Let's call it, you know, let's make a copy of trained soldier, right? This will sound like it's cheating that you're just making copies of everything. I promise you this is the way very good, very powerful mods get made in Little Wargame, right? It's just you copy from something somewhat simpler, you twist it a little bit, and then it becomes effective. So we're going to take trained soldier, and we don't want to call this trained soldier. Right? Let's see what the name is. Yeah, this calls itself Train Soldier. We don't want to call it Train Soldier. We want it to call, like, Train New Faction. What do we want to call our new faction unit? Let's call it Can. Train Can. Okay. Let's see, a new faction unit, we'll just call it Fact, okay? Train Fact. And now we have an ability called Train Fact. We can also call this Z Train Fact to make it appear at the bottom of the screen. Let's go ahead and do that, Z Train Fact. Now, Train Fact is just a copy of our soldier ability, right? But notice what we're going to do here, okay? The command card is 0. It's the first thing on our Clippers building, right? And we notice here that it's going to be called, it's going to make unit, just like we were making unit of a building. This is going to make a unit of a soldier. So let's cut one step through and make a new copy of the soldier, tweak it a little bit, and then we'll train that unit instead. So we're going to go to new, and we're going to copy our soldier. And our ability to make this new unit is called train fact. So it only makes sense that the unit that we're making is going to be called a fact. There we go. Z fact. Because it comes from a, you know, factory is the kind of thinking that we've got here, right? Doesn't really matter, or new fact as in new faction. So our Z fact is just a soldier, but it's our soldier. Let's go through a couple of things we can do to make this soldier feel a little bit different, right? I always wanted my soldiers to have 500 hit points and 2 base armor. But then I don't want it to, you know, and then I want its damage to be 25. And I want its weapon cooldown. So this is the most complicated one that we've introduced. Hit points, it's just how many hit points the unit has. We know what that means. Armor, it's how much damage it can, you know, how much damage it ignores. We know what that means. But movement speed, it's how fast it moves. Well, what's weapon cooldown? Well, weapon cooldown is how many seconds the game takes before the unit can attack again. So by default, a soldier takes 1.15 seconds. We're going to lower that to 1 second. We're going to take its damage and send it from 18 to 25. Now, here's the thing. We've just changed a couple of numbers, but this is now an entirely different unit than the soldier. It is, in fact, the most cracked version of the soldier ever made. So let's go back to our abilities. I'm going to scroll all the way down, because now what we have to do is we have to give our Clippers building, our new faction barracks building, the ability to train a fact. Okay, so it's a make unit, and currently it is of type soldier. We're going to scroll again all the way to the bottom, and we're going to go from unit type that we want it to make to be a fact. That's just the name of our new unit. Remember how we changed barracks to new faction barracks for all these abilities? We're going to do the same thing here, right? We're going to call it, instead of a soldier, we're going to call it a fact.supply. Fact.build time. Fact.description. Now, let's go change those a little bit. And we're going to make it a little silly, but this will help people know what your new unit is. Because when they highlight it and it's referencing this build time and this supply and this description, where can we go for those? Well, supply, the amount of supply this unit uses. This seems like way too good of a version of a soldier. We're going to make it cost 4 supply instead of 2. Now we're going to go down and we want to see its build time. Well, this takes 25 seconds. How are we going to see that happen quickly? We're going to make it take 10 seconds to build. Its cost. It currently costs 80. We'll make it cost 150, just to change some numbers. Now, description. Soldiers are basic melee combat unit. Well, we don't want to call it. This isn't a soldier, so we're just going to say facts are my new faction version of a soldier. Okay. Now, we're going to go ahead and save and test. And we're going to see how all this builds on each other. We're going to press T to go to our build Clippers. We're going to press Q. It's going to build. It's going to build quickly and cost 200 gold. Okay. Now this is going to be made. And we're going to see a problem. Can you guess what the problem is? Come on, everyone. Can you guess what the problem is? Yep. We didn't add the ability to the building. So let's go ahead and do that. F10 plus N. And we're going to give ourselves a little more gold. So we're going to go to settings. We're going to give ourselves 5,000 starting gold, just to show the example. Now, even just like when we made the command card, but we couldn't... We made the command card, but it didn't see any abilities to make the building. So we had to add the make building to the command card. We have to add the ability to train a fact, this new ability, to our building. So let's go to our new faction barracks. Scroll down slowly this time, because we have no commands. So we have to find it. There we go. Commands. Add. We'll go all the way to the bottom again. And we'll go to train fact. And now we're going to save and we're going to test. Notice that we have 5,000 gold. It's going to make it really easy for us to build stuff now. And now we're going to build this new faction barracks. With this new faction barracks finished, ding. Notice that it now has the ability to train fact. It's cost 150 gold. It has 4 supply. The duration, or build time, is 10 seconds. And it says, facts are my new faction version of a soldier. We press Q. Holy hell, we've made a Z fact. It looks like a soldier, but it's got 500 health, 25 damage. It attacks super fast. Look at this thing. Watch this. That's right. Oh, sick. Okay, and now, unbelievably, you might not believe me, you have everything you need to start making your faction. I know I only showed you how to make this one command card, but you can use this command card to create all a space for all of the buildings you want your new faction to have. I know I only showed you how to make one building, right? But we didn't just show you how to make a new building. We showed you how to make a new building, how to make it so that it can train a unit, so that the new unit inside is trainable. So this worker has a command card that only has one build clippers. But you could add nine other buildings to this same command card. This new faction barracks can only make a trained fact, which is a copy of the soldier. But you can change the values of this soldier, or maybe you want to copy a raider, maybe you want to copy a mage, maybe you want to copy a werewolf, maybe you want to copy a catapult or a gatling gun or an airship, right? And you can change their values to whatever you want them to be. Right now, the new faction barracks can only train these facts. You can add nine new units to this one building. Okay? And that, listen, that's not everything. Okay? We haven't talked about research requirements. We haven't talked about how do you make upgrades for your faction, right? We haven't talked about tags or modifiers. Making spellcasters is going to be a little bit weird, but I don't want you to get into all of that yet, right? Just enjoy the simple joy of going through and making your own copy customed, like take a copy of something that exists and tweak it a little bit and make a new building and tweak it a little bit and add some new units. Sure, there'll be copies of units at first. I can't tell you how many times I've seen that, and that's fine. You actually can play with the editor. I know it looks huge and scary, but if you followed through this tutorial that I just made, you know how to make command cards, how to make new buildings, how to make those buildings make new units, and how to copy and make new units for yourself. So I hope that'll help you with everything. Aver, this is out for you. I'm going to try and make something like this more regularly, where I've noticed there's a lot of requests of how do you make this thing? How do you do this thing? And I think instead of streaming regularly, I'll do this as a series of, hey, we'll just stream something really quickly, get the ideas out there so I can point it to people in Discord because the video is too large for Discord otherwise, and then put it on YouTube somewhere. And that way you'll have access to it forever and ever. Now, I hope that was really helpful to you, Aver. Go forth and kick some ass and make something awesome.